Welcome back to my YouTube channel. Thanks so much for clicking on this video today. We're back with the Vlogmas. We took a little break, but we're back. And in today's video, I just wanted to have a quick little chat with you about our mental health during this holiday season. A lot of people ask me how I stay so positive, how I have such a positive outlook on life, or like how I seem like I'm always happy and all of this stuff. And the truth is, you know, just like everyone else, I'm not happy all the time. You know, just like everyone else, I have a story. I've gone through some things. I just wanted to make a quick little video about the holidays and how I know that it can be tough, because I definitely feel it. When you lose someone in your family and then the holidays come up, they're really hard. It's really hard to get through them because you feel that missing place in your family. And I know some of you have felt that before. If you've had any sort of loss in your life, whether that is a death in the family or whether that's just losing someone really close to you that you're not friends with anymore, or that you broke up with, all of that is painful, and all of your pain in those feelings is justified. So if you ever feel like everyone around you seems happy, or everyone seems bubbly, or everyone seems like they have their life together, I promise you, you are not alone in your feelings. If anything, you have one other person there with you, and that is me. I know this is gonna end up super like rambly. I just wanted to tell you that I know that it's hard. I know that you can see the Christmas lights up and you can see family celebrating, and if you've lost a loved one in your life, it can be really hard to see that. Not that you wish ill will on anyone, but just seeing other families complete can be really tough on you if you've lost someone. And my family lost someone during the holidays, so that's why I just wanted to share with you that you're not alone. I promise you, you're not alone in your feelings. You're not alone in your grief. You're not alone as much as you may feel that you are, if you ever feel that way, because I've definitely felt that way. I'm the kind of person, I don't like to feel things right away, so I kind of push them down. I don't like to deal with them, so I would rather look on the bright side, which, you know, is a good and a negative, because it means I can find the bright side, I can find the good shiny things that are still in my life. But sometimes I do that at the cost of not dealing with my grief or with pain. I just wanted to share with you kind of what I'm going through and kind of that side of it, just so you guys know that it's not all sunshine and rainbows here all the time, and it's okay that it's not, as long as we can always find the reasons that make it good. Find the reasons why we get up in the morning. Remember all the small things that make us happy. I have a hard time dealing with grief. I haven't really processed a lot of things with that. I kind of use smiling and laughing as a defense mechanism because I'm not really ready to deal with all of that. But you know, I've taken one big step this semester, and that's going to therapy. I started going to therapy a couple months ago to kind of deal with my emotions, to deal with anything I have built up, because, you know, I say it all the time, the gym's my happy place, and the gym is what helped me through some really hard times. It helped me stand back on my feet, but, you know, I still have to work through some deeper issues there. And I'm starting to do that in therapy, and I just thought I'd share that with you because maybe you're a little hesitant about therapy, maybe you're nervous, you don't want it to seem like there's something wrong with you, and that's not what that means at all. For me, I look at it as a place where I can talk out loud about everything that I process in my head. Sorry if I just am like bringing the mood down a bit, you know, I don't mean to. I try to be happy and bubbly a lot of the time, but I wanted to take a breather and let you know that you are not alone in anything that you feel. Everything that you feel is justified. You have gone through it. You have had your own ups and downs in your life. You have gone through things. And look where you are. Look where you're standing. That's so amazing. That's so amazing to me. How we can go through so many terrible things, so many hard, rough parts of our lives, and still end up on the other side, and you're living proof of that. Look how strong you are. Oh my gosh. Okay, I'll just kind of end this video here. That's gonna be the Vlogmas video today. I'm so sorry if this was like a little dark. I didn't mean it that way. Bottom line is, I just wanted to let you know that you're not alone in anything that you're feeling. Everyone's feeling different things all the time, and we're all justified in all of our feelings. Thank you so much for watching this video, and don't forget to hit the subscribe button, because we're back on track officially with Vlogmas, because my finals are behind me. Done. They're done. Whew! That was the longest 3 weeks of my life. And I hope you have a terrific day and a terrific week, and I will see you all tomorrow. I promise. I promise I'll see you tomorrow. We're on track. Everything's good.